Iterative deepening may look hard at first, but it has some nice properties. Let's take a basic framework of depth-first search. To make this iterative, add a depth counter. Depth 0 is not usually the goal, so you then do a complete search to depth 1. Then search to depth 2, and then to depth 3. Work is repeated because some nodes are visited more than once, but there are advantages. First, it's optimal, so it finds shorter solutions before longer ones. And it's complete. It won't get stuck in infinite loops. To see another plus, consider a maze-solving situation. You can get through this maze just by trial and error. But it would be nice to avoid all these dead ends. You may have an algorithm that can figure out a path to the goal, given some time. But some mazes can be big. You don't want to just stand and wait at the entrance while the algorithm works. You'd like to start and get the current best answer at each decision point, even if the algorithm hasn't finished yet. Algorithms that you can interrupt in this way to find their current best guess are called anytime algorithms. Ideally, the quality of the solution should improve the longer the algorithm is allowed to run. The game of chess was the first place in AI where iterative search was suggested. Adrian de Groot called it progressive deepening. Chess clocks restrict decision time, so flexible algorithms have an advantage. For any time use, nodes need evaluations, so we can pick the best. As an example, we'll use a path cost function, g. The best choice is AB at depth 1, ABE at depth 2, and the best of the two possible paths to depth 3 is ACFG. The math shows that the overhead of repeating nodes on each iteration is small. The x-axis on this graph is the branching factor of the search, and the y-axis is the overhead, calculated by summing all the nodes that iterative deepening has to look at. So the algorithm does not cost much extra time, is complete and optimal, and has the low memory use of DFS. The early chess programmers were surprised to find one more benefit. Iterating to depth D could take less time than a straight search to that level. Their programs could use the results of one iteration to reorder nodes when searching deeper. If this led to pruning by heuristics like alpha-beta, time at the costly deeper levels could be saved.